Welcome back to the next video in the MSP Marketing Pillar Series. And today we're talking about possibly one of the most overlooked terms when it comes to your marketing strategy, and that is the top five things to check off when looking at your own website. First of all, hi, my name is Pete Matheson, and in early 2020, I sold my MSP IT business, which I started in 2011 and grew over the next pretty much a decade. Since then, I'm now coaching other IT business owners to help them achieve similar, if hopefully not greater, success than I did. Now, when looking at your marketing pillars, of which you should have a few, your website is probably one of the first ones that you would have taken care of, but there are a number of issues that I come across time and time again, which will seriously impact how well it works for you. And whilst you're watching this, let us know in the comments below if you've experienced any of these issues with websites you visited. Before we do get started, a quick thanks to our sponsor for this video. Continuity Marketing are the smartest marketers in tech. They support IT businesses, MSPs, and vendors to work smarter, generate leads, and thrive as a business. The team is full of marketing experts who come from the tech space, so they really know what they're doing. If you need to build your brand, raise awareness, and sell your services and products, Continuity Marketing can help. Start working smarter today and visit continuity.uk or email info@continuity.uk. So here is my top five checklist, which you can hopefully check off to make sure that you aren't falling into this same trap on your own website. First up is, what do you do? It should be blindingly obvious of what you do when someone lands on your website. So we're talking about a clear headline message that can be understood within just a few seconds of them landing on your page. We're talking above the fold here. And when I say above the fold, I mean that it should be visible without the visitor having to then scroll. This means a desktop, laptop, or even a mobile phone. A clear message like IT support for business can go down super well. And depending on your target audience, I would try and stay away from using words like MSP and MSSP, because nobody really knows what that means other than us. Number two is your contact information. Much like the first one, your contact information should be on clear display for all to see. And this typically means you're putting at least the telephone number in the top banner of your website, perhaps even an email address or at least an obvious link to contact us, which can maybe take them to a more secure form that can't be spammed as much. Which also leads me on to, don't put an image of your telephone number in your header and think you've solved this magical problem of being spammed by phone calls. A, it makes it super difficult for people to contact you because they can't easily tap on the phone number to, call them from their mobile. B, when you come to implementing services such as CallRail, which changes the phone number people see on your website depending on where they've come from, well, you just can't do it as it just doesn't work. And C, well, from my experience, it doesn't actually achieve anything. I mean, really? I've had phone numbers on all of my websites for decades. I've never had an issue with spammy phone calls, ever. So again, simple, plain text phone number in the top banner of your website. So when someone lands on it, they can just tap on it and it will then ring you. Simple. Number three is photos and personality. I can't stress how many MSP websites I look over and all I see are the same stock photos time and time again. Some of them even get a little bit creative and butcher those stock photos to insert maybe their logo onto people's shirts or maybe the signage behind them. But you may not have realized recently that people kind of do business with people. It honestly doesn't take much and it's not expensive, but hire a photographer for just 1 hour to take headshots of all of your staff on a clean background, a nice white background. Then you simply cut the background out and then you can start putting some real faces onto your website. Yes, you could even put those real photos on top of the stock photography for backgrounds if you want to pretend that your engineers are standing in a data center or something. But the point is that the staff are real. This is Paul, he works in our engineering team. Meet Sarah, she works on our account management team. Meet Pete, he owns the business. The number of times I see websites that don't even show the face of the owner just astounds me. Number four is accreditations and awards. And if you are a smaller, more local business, then only local awards around how good your customer services is, then shout about it. If you are a larger firm, then maybe some nationwide awards would look great, but do be careful here, as there are so many so-called awards that people win because they kind of pay for the editorial, which is basically paying to win the award. Congratulations, you have won the award for the best MSP in the world ever. To claim your prize, all you need to do is send payment through for £3,000 and we will ship the award to you and give you a full double page spread in our magazine. That is not a legitimate award. So my advice here is just to be careful and use awards that are recognized amongst your prospects. When it comes to accreditations, there are two rules. Number one, don't lie. Number two, keep them up to date. A good friend of mine has a tool which has scraped the company's house data for IT companies here in the UK and discovered there were more companies with websites claiming to be a Microsoft Gold Partner than Microsoft's own website states. So something fishy is going on there. And finally, that brings us on to number 5, testimonials. Much like point number 3 around real photos, people want to see real reviews and real testimonials. This means you should be making an effort to collect and store those testimonials regularly as part of your day-to-day business. And I've also made a couple of videos about collecting those testimonials. Click up here and down below in the description for more of those. Collect feedback and comments around both your day-to-day support service, as that is just a huge resource of feedback just waiting to be tapped. But also collect feedback around your overall service and from the senior leaders in your customers. Now, ideally this should be in video format, but written is fine too, and since many still don't like to appear on video and something like a written case study may be more comfortable for them than being on camera. But with that said, there is still nothing better than a customer doing all the selling for you whilst they talk about how efficient or reactive or understanding you have been whilst delivering your services. Create a dedicated page on your website for testimonials and fill it to the brim with as many as you can, ideally automated so that when customers are visiting, they see a steady stream of recent testimonials rather than those, you know, one or two handpicked which made the cut to appear on your website. And there you have it with my top 5 recommendations when looking at your website as a marketing pillar. But wait, there's more. To finish off this video, I'm gonna add 4 quick bonus tips around your website. First of all, add a call to action to every page, whether it's to click a button and book a meeting or pick up the phone and give you a call, just anything. Second, if you're running short on video content, and particularly for your products and services pages, well, many vendors provide white labeled videos, which you can use across your website super easily. Though, as in my previous videos about video, I would always recommend creating a personal video if you have the skills to do so. But if not, then those videos are a fantastic resource. Third, don't make websites too wordy. No one wants to read hundreds of words, so keep it short, to the point, and always engaging enough to encourage people to want to talk to you. And lastly, fourth, add your social media links to your website. It's just so easy to do. Make sure you subscribe for more top tips, comment down below with any others that you've seen for yourself, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks, bye-bye.